Go fishing, Joe. So yesterday was our first day in the quarry. We spent most of it clearing up. You can thank Joe for that. And in the cleaning process, we did get some nicer fish over here. You can see a nice diplo right there. Another diplo, some pretty nightias, and then Joe got a couple of Pheriotis, which are in that block, and then a big 15-inch Myoplosis. So, gonna spend another full day digging it up, finding some stuff. Joe, what do you have?
I got a stingray.
Oh my god, that is beautiful.
Nice positive and negative. I think the rest of it's going in that corner over
there. Let me take a look. That corner right there?
Yeah, see how the ripples in this rock go like that?
Yeah,
that
I see.
Concentric ripple, with the concentric ripple right there. So the rest of it's going to be in two pieces right in that crease right there.
That's going to look so nice too.
Yep.
Once it's all put together.
That's gorgeous, dark brownish red color because it's right by the bottom of the quarry. And should have a full positive and negative of it. Nice.
Nice.
You know what shame is? Look at the mortality layer. Blank.
Blank.
There's one fish that looks like it's undercover on the back of that end.
That is a pretty Pheriotis. Look at those teeth. Pheriotis.
Nice dark chocolate brown color.
And you got the fish right
there. It's just a shame it's split right on the face like that and left the body and tail on that side.
Yep.
Oh well, it'll make a good positive and negative.
Wow, that is really cool.
That's really cool. Again, another nice positive and negative.
Yep.
It's day three that we're gonna be digging here in Kemmerer, Wyoming in the Green River Formation. Not exactly luxurious living standards. I've modified my dad's expedition to be able to sleep in, but it is definitely got a good view. You see way in the distance, there's still snow on some of those peaks. But we're gonna get back out there, hopefully find something else really nice. So stay tuned, guys. Gotta wake up.
We've been making a lot of progress with this rock. Moved a ton of overburden over there where Joe's working. And there have been plenty of pretty fish. It's a Myoplosis right there. So this is really cool. Kim, one of the other diggers here, was thinning down a plate with two fish on it. And you've got on this side the two fish here and here. While he was thinning it down, he found something nice. It is a beautiful, well, it's gonna be a beautiful ferro when you finish prepping it, Kim. Congrats.
Thank you. It flipped right on.
It peeled really bad.
Yeah, it peeled right on. It left the everything here,
all
the stingers broke off, and so it.
That's pretty incredible, still, Kim.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, it's kind of cool.
Kim strikes again. Really awesome puddle layer assemblage. Lots and lots and lots of fish. That would have been a nice smile too.
Right in the middle with
them. Oh well. This might not look like anything special, but this is literally a cool ass shit. So gar, one of the rarer fish in the Green River Formation, and whatever animal this was, a big turtle, a croc, it ate a gar, and you can see it really well right there for that one. But there are gar scales all throughout this poop. You can kind of see them up in here. But that's pretty cool and really rare. Nice. Very nice. So we're nearing the end of the day over here, and I just got a pretty fish. It is a pretty big diplo, probably around a foot. And that'll look nice. It came out in a couple pieces. This right here is where the rock with the tail, but that should prep out nice. Nearing the end of the day. Didn't lose anything. Somewhere in this 4 foot pile of tailings. Tails on the tailings, Joe. So earlier I mentioned that the views out here are pretty beautiful. Well, even from the crapper, it's pretty nice. And there's no one out here, so you can do your poo and, well, have a view. If you want to talk about something really cool, I was not expecting to split this rock and get that beautiful leaf from it. Ah, it's so cool. Never really know what's gonna come out of these layers. Pretty happy with it. That is an Asiniops. Call it the mystery fish, because the family it comes from is very poorly understood.
This is the better side.
Ah, it came out beautifully on the ash layer. Joe, how rare is that?
There's only been like 30 come from this lake.
It's pretty incredible. Personal collection, bro?
Yep.
Personal collection. That's awesome. Found another ray. That is always so cool to see them come out. It's gonna take quite a bit of prep. The rest of it's going into the wall. Oop, almost fell. Where Joe's playing around at. Cool. You can see right here, vertebrae, and then the disc is coming out. Looks like that. It's covered and buried though.
Very tip of the rays over here, but it looks like the majority of it will be in this block.
Very cool.
Right here.
Well, I guess I'm gonna go ahead and start taking out that block.
No, bottom this out first.
Okay. Yeah. Cool.
Then we can chase that ray.
So they're currently working on freeing up some rock with the backhoe, and this huge crocodile tooth just dumped out of the wall. Let's see if I can't get the camera to focus on it. That thing is big and beautiful. It would have been one mean animal.
Started a fresh day. Hopefully we'll find some cool stuff. Wish us luck. Got more hunting to do. This is day 11 out of 20 days of hunting, so. Woo!
So on this ash plate,
is that
that tail right there? That's the tail of a ray. And so they're trying to find the rest of it in the wall.
See barb laying on the top of the tail right there?
He's pointing at the barb and the tail of the stingray. A lot of nice fish on that plate. Hopefully they can grab it. Monster D9 in the background working.
No.
Hopefully they find it. That's so cool. That's a penny for scale. A couple of German tourists yesterday found this baby little ray.
That is absolutely adorable.
Good lord, it's so cute. Oh man. That is a negative. So I'm splitting rock, and I see this nice outline here. Let's. Oh yeah, that is a juvenile feral. Let's see if you can see the teeth, if it'll focus in on them. That is a cool fish, yeah. Look at those teeth. piranha. Ah, that's so cool. Oh, that is bright. There's Joe slipping his rock. God, that's cool. And it's covered up, so we got the vertebrae coming down, and that'll prep out nice little piranha. So it looks like this pair of fish have been best buddies for a very long time. Split open this small rock, and we got this pair of cool crossfish. That is awesome. Joe's over there beating up on the rock. Nice dip up too. Oof. Get it, Joe. Get it. So we're over across the hill at the other quarry, and we got a rock x-ray that we think has a bird. And if you look right here, you've got finger bone, finger bone, and right there is the claw. And you've got long bones right here from the limbs, and you got another limb right here. There might be more, but we're not sure. There's the culprit rock.
No cross sections there, that side, and it looks like from the x-ray there's something coming all the way up to here.
Oh my goodness. I had no idea that those would come out that nice, Joe.
It turned out nice. It took almost 15 hours.
What'd you use to prep it?
A needle in a stick.
A needle in a stick?
I stuck a sewing needle in the end of a stick. And prepared it under about 70x magnification.
And so these are bird leg, right?
Yeah,
bird legs.
They're from some sort of wading bird because of the length of this bone. But I haven't determined which one yet. Some sort of early Eocene wading bird.
That is so rare and beautiful.
The lake that these come from is one of the few places that preserves anything that falls into it. So these birds would have washed in from the shore and been preserved in the limestone sediments in the middle of the lake. Even so, they're ridiculously rare.
That's cool. And then there might be a stingray in here. Well, there probably is. There's a cross section right up here. You can see the stingray coming, a stinger coming out, and maybe a vertebrae, but we're not 100% sure. So this is Joe's stingray, and you can see the vertebrae line coming down, getting larger and larger. And the center of the disc is going to be right around this area. God, that's so cool.
Where the large vertebrae end right there.
Yep.
So the disc will come out like that.
Right.
Thank you so much, Doc, for letting us do this. This is awesome.
Okay, well, you guys, yeah.
There's the stingray right there. Cool. So we are back in Florida, and Joe has spent 10 hours putting together this beautiful ray. I cannot believe that he found this simply from the cross section of the stingray right there. And then we got it x-rayed, brought it back to Florida, and this madman made a beautiful piece of art app. Well, to be fair, nature made the art. He just perfected it.
I exposed the art.
You exposed the art?
Yeah. And who do you think put the tail back on?
You?
I put the tail back on. And I made it so you can put it up on the wall, too.
Wall?
Oh.
He is a multifaceted renaissance man. That's amazing. That detail. Goodness. So, we're back in Florida, where it's hot and miserable.
Look at that one.
Oh my goodness. And so Joe's taking me into his fossil shed to see some of these beautiful fish after they've been prepped. Little ray, Nadia. Ooh, what do we have here, buddy?
These are some of my better ones. This is a myoplosis with a little leaf next to it, and it's on a layer with some volcanic ash that I've left on top of it that kind of comes in a diagonal stripe through it, and I've framed it nicely.
That's cool.
And that's a big piranha. It's about 2 foot long.
Holy crap.
It's a Pheriobis incostus. It's the best one I've ever found.
You know, it's funny. When we were there and we were finishing up hunting, I was so ready to be back in Florida, backbreaking work. Like, Joe's put in so much effort in this, and I was there the whole time, and I know what it's like now. But now that I'm back in Florida, all I want to be doing is finding more fish. Like, oh, this is Joe's setup. You can see he started prepping this fish right here.
I got the jaw done, and then I started to find how deep the body was.
Yeah, Joe has to put a lot of work into this. How many hours do you think would go into a fish like that?
Probably 9 or 10 more.
Yep. That was an awesome trip. Really enjoyed hanging out with Joe and going out west and doing something really different and awesome. Can't wait to do it hopefully in the future again, but thanks so much for watching, guys. Make sure to like, follow, subscribe, and thank you. Take care.